This morning, as you can probably tell, we're getting a head start on Christmas and baking up a snowstorm with some delicious festive treats. Chef Sophie Morris joins me now with some beautifully delicious brownies. And the smell here, even at 9:30 in the morning, I'm not complaining. Good morning, Sophie. How are you?
Good morning, Laura. I'm good. I'm good. I'm making some lovely Christmas brownies with cranberries and mixed spice.
I'm embarrassed to say I can't make brownies. Now, I have tried in the past.
This is a simple one. You'll definitely have to do this one.
I'm really good at cooking, but for some reason, baking does and I just don't go well together. So please take me through step
by
step.
We will. Okay, so the first thing to do is melt together 300 grams of dark chocolate with 220 grams of Kerrygold butter, which I've got in here.
Why dark chocolate?
The dark just gives it a really lovely flavour. Yeah, you need the dark for brownies, I think. Yeah, really chocolatey. That's what you want.
Okay.
So I'm going to melt that together over a pan of simmering water. The main thing is to not let the bowl touch the water, otherwise the chocolate could seize. So I've got it nearly melted there. And just while that's finishing off, the next step is, while that's melting, you are going to whisk together 4 eggs with 300 grams of light muscovado sugar. Okay, so again, I've started whisking, so I'll just finish it off quickly. Okay, so
well organized.
You normally whisk that for about 3 or 4 minutes until it goes a lovely kind of pale and fluffy colour, and that's good because it makes the brownies rise. So
and there's
really
no problem if you do it a little bit too long or anything like that.
No problem. No,
we're trying to see where the problems
totally
might occur.
Totally foolproof.
Okay,
so then we've got that, and we're gonna mix. Now the butter and chocolate is fully melted, so we're just gonna combine that with the eggs and the sugar.
Okay. This is such a fun recipe for little
ones
really to get involved with.
This
as well.
Is when you want to start licking the bowl, I think.
I know. Well, my little charge at home would tend to just sit and lick the bowl.
You can't
leave me to the rest of it.
It's irresistible, really, isn't it?
Okay,
so we're just going to mix all that together.
Fold it in,
It looks gorgeous. Okay.
I'm surprised you used dark chocolate because I would have thought that it would have been a little bit too rich, but I suppose when you're putting that much.
I think, when you put in
that
the
many eggs and,
there's 4 eggs, so there's quite a lot of egg and sugar, and then. There's going to be nuts in it and some cranberries, and that just it gives a lovely kind of sweetness as well to the dark chocolate. So then we're just going to fold in 200 grams of plain flour.
Okay.
And then to give it a lovely Christmassy flavour, 1 teaspoon of mixed spice.
Oh, lovely.
That really nice kind of Christmassy.
A little bit of cinnamon
taste.
Or something in there.
Yeah, exactly.
Gorgeous.
Very like cinnamon. So just fold all that in.
Lots of Christmas flavour.
Yeah.
And I mean, really, you wouldn't make the recipe any other way, though, for any other time of year, would you?
No, exactly. They're really nice for Christmas and with the cranberries and everything. Lovely Christmassy feel. So then we just add 100 grams of dried cranberries and 100 grams of chopped pecans. Now, you don't need to put in the pecans if you don't want nuts, but I love the kind of crunchy
texture. The texture,
So just pour them in with the cranberries. That's pretty much it.
Lovely. See,
pretty simple.
You're looking at me as if to say, so why could you not do that? Trust me.
You definitely need to
I'll
try
be taking
this
yours home with me today and pretending.
Oh, it's a really lovely one to do with the kids, I think.
It
I
is
really
lovely.
Like, especially with the melting of the chocolate and everything. It's lovely.
And how is your fab career going? Good,
great,
I hope.
Great, yeah, all is going really well.
A busy
yeah.
time of year for you,
Very
I imagine.
Very busy, yeah. Christmas
because
is.
If we ever do baking at one time of the year, it's Christmas time.
It is.
We pretend to be
so
a whiz
I've
at the
been
kitchen.
Doing lots of baking recently, but.
I could see some of your goodies over there, of course, your own cookies and some
Loans
cupcakes and everything.
And Rice Krispie squares and, yeah.
You need to have a strong
Lots
arm for
you
this.
All to eat after this. So there we go. So that's all mixed together. So then I'm just going to pour it into my prepared tin. So
how many is this going to make?
It makes a good, well, it's how big you want to cut the squares, but okay. Like kind of 8 big ones.
Lovely.
So I've just greased with butter the tin and then lined it with baking parchment. And then we just pour it all in. Like
Lovely.
That. Yummy.
You can see the lovely texture there with the cranberries and nuts, can't you?
Lovely texture. But again, you don't need to put them in if you don't want, if you want to just straightforward brownies. Okay, then we just pop that into the oven at 180 degrees for about 30 minutes.
Okay. Okay? And what's this whole thing with the knife in the middle? If it comes out clean, then they're done. Some
with
people
brownies,
like their brownies chewy.
With brownies, I think more just that the top is firm, you know?
Okay, and this is our
finished one.
Look at this, our finished tray of brownies.
So there we go.
Oh, that just looks so deliciously edible.
Just let it cool and then cut it into squares, okay? So I'm going to do really nice big squares.
Thank you, Sophie. Thank you so much for that. Unfortunately, Mark isn't around. Thank you so much, Sophie. You're cutting them into squares here and I've got my beady eye on them. Thank you so much. Go on, just show us a little bit of sugar quickly.
Yeah, if you make a little Christmas stencil, then you can just put some icing sugar over it and make a nice star shape on your brownie.
And with that, I'm feeling very festive. Sophie Morris, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Coming up, Alan's last hurrah from segueing to horse riding. Alan Hughes is working up a sweat on his last day in Malta. Stay with us. Thanks, Sophie.